Hi, welcome to Tips and Tricks in Lucidspark. In this video, I'm going to share a few best practices with you that are going to help you be as efficient as possible while working in Lucidspark. Now, this first tip that I wanted to share is the quickest way to create a new board. Instead of visiting the homepage and then having to click on a bunch of buttons, all that you really need to do is open up a new tab or browser, type in lucidspark.new into the URL, and press Enter on your keyboard. As long as you've already signed into Lucid and authenticated, you'll be able to create new boards in no time. The next tip that I wanted to share is how to quickly create sticky notes. Now, you might be in a scenario where maybe you need to take a lot of notes or you're adding ideas to the board really quickly. You can do that by simply adding one sticky note and then using our keyboard shortcuts to add additional ones. So you can use Tab to move to the right, Enter or Return to move down, Shift and Tab to the left, and Shift and Enter or Return to move back up. And by doing this, you'll be able to create new sticky notes really efficiently. You can also add text to those sticky notes as you're typing along the way. Now, there might be times where you've got a lot of ideas on the board and it's hard to draw those relationships or see all of those ideas together. So all you need to do in that scenario is click on your canvas, lasso all of your sticky notes, and then move up here and click on Quick Cleanup. And this will arrange all of your sticky notes in a line so that you can view them really efficiently. Now, there also might be times during a brainstorming session where maybe one idea or sticky note is larger than the others. So in order to level the playing field, all you need to do is click and drag to select all of your sticky notes, then right-click on the one you want everything else to match size with, and then select Match Size, and that will make sure that all of your sticky notes are that exact same size so that you can level that playing field. Now, there might be times where you're designing a board or adding shapes onto the board, and you might notice that as you start to click and drag to rearrange and resize those shapes, that they start to get a little bit wonky. If you wanted to lock in that exact ratio, so I wanted this to stay as a circle, if I hold the Shift key while I do this, that will lock in those dimensions so that I can keep a circle on my canvas. Another time, you might need to quickly create multiple copies of things. And to do that, instead of holding Command and C or Command and V, all you need to do is click on the object, hold down the Option or Alt key, and then drag to move that object over, and you'll have multiple copies. Another pro tip with this is if you hold the Option key and then also hold down the Shift key, you can drag that object over and lock it into that same field and plane so that as I move my cursor down here, you can see that Dolly the sheep stays in the same line as that other object, or I could do the same thing vertically as well. Also, when designing a board, you might notice certain times where maybe all of your objects aren't perfectly aligned, or maybe you need them just slightly out of alignment for a particular reason. Well, you can quickly move those items by using the arrow keys. So if I were to click on the tortoise here, I could then move him forward using my arrow key and have him cross the finish line. Or in the case of the bunny rabbit, if I wanted to move my arrow keys and move him all the way over here, maybe I didn't want his ear to cross the finish line, but I wanted his nose to cross the finish line. If you hold the Shift key and then use the arrow keys, that will allow you to do micro adjustments. So now you can see I've tapped it enough times that the bunny rabbit's nose is across the finish lines, but his ears are still behind the finish line, making it really easy to make any kind of adjustments I need on my canvas. And last but not least, we've got the canvas menu. Now, this is a quick way to access any of the features available to you within Lucidspark. To do it, just press the forward slash key and you'll notice this menu appears. You can scroll down to find the item that you're looking for, or if you're not seeing the item that you want there and you know it, like I want GIFs added in here, I can click on GIFs. That opens it up over here for me and I can quickly click and drag to add that GIF to my canvas. So if you like this video and you want to learn even more tips and tricks, you can press the function key on your keyboard or FN key and then press F1, and that will open up all of our shortcuts that you will be able to learn and master to be as efficient as possible. Or if you wanted to practice and get a little more hands-on, you can move down here to the question mark, which is our learning center, and then select one of these thumbnails to walk through an experience or watch a video to learn how to do things while you're in the canvas at the same time. Well, thank you for watching and we hope you enjoyed this video. Keep practicing those shortcuts and you'll be a Lucidspark master in no time.